Hi students, welcome to Justin NCERT Solutions. In this video we are going to see 600 maths chapter 3 divisibility rules. First we are going to check it for divisibility by 10. If ones place of a number is 0, if ones place is 0, then that number is divisible by 10. Now we will see that, and in for all the sums we will write only the hint, we will not write the whole statement, we will write only the hint. Ones place is 0, then it is divisible by 10. Now listen, we will check that examples. Example, we will take number 20. 20 is divisible by 10. 0, 0 cancel, remaining answer is 2. And if you are taking 100, last ones place is 0, 0, 0 cancel, answer is 10. So like that, for all the numbers, if it is having ones place is 0, that number is divisible by 10. Next, divisible by 5. Divisible by 5. If ones place is, if ones place is either 0 or 5. Ones place is either 0 or 5, it is divisible by 5. We will check it by using examples. Example, we will take it. We will take number 15. Ones place is ending with 5. We will check it for 5. 1 5 is 5, 3 5s are 15. Next we will take number 50. Ones place is ending with 0. We are going to divide it by 5. 10 5s are 50. So like this we can give a number of examples. If ones place is ending with 0 or 5, then it is divisible by 5. Next, by 2. Divisibility by 2. If ones place is, ones place is ending with 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. If ones place is ending with 2, 4, 6, 8, 0, then it is divisible by 2. We will check it by using examples. Example, we will take number 12. 6 2s are 12. Next we will take number 14. We are dividing by 2, 7. Next we will take it 36. Last number ending with 6. We will check it. 18 2s are 36. Like that we can give any examples. Now we are going to check it for 3. Divisibility by 3. If sum of its digits is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. Sum of its digits are divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. Sum of its digits are divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. We will check it by using examples. We will take number 33. Example, 33 we have taken. Sum of its digits, 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. The 6 is divisible by 3. Therefore, 33 is divisible by 3. We will check it by using example 11 3s are 33. And next, second example 99 is equal to 9 plus 9 is equal to 18 divided by 3. 18 is divisible by 3. So we will check it. 99 divided by 3 is equal to 33. So that number is divisible by 3. And we will take some other number. 543. 5 plus 4 plus 3 is equal to 9 plus 3, 12 divisible by 3. So this 543 divisible by 3, we will check it. In 5 we have only 1 3 is there, remaining 2. In 24 we have 8 3s are there, then remaining 1. In 3 we have only 1 3, so 181. Therefore, if sum of its digits are divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. We have seen that by using the examples. Next, divisible by 6. Divisibility by 6. If a number is divisible by both 2 and 3. If a number is divisible by both 2 and 3, if a number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then it is divisible by 6 also. If a number is divisible by 2 and 3, then it is divisible by 6. If a number is divisible by only 2, it is not divisible by 6. When a number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then the number is divisible by 6. We will check it by using examples. We will take 24 divided by 2 is equal to 12. Next we will check it for 24 divided by 3 is equal to 8 3s are 24. Now we will check it for 6. 24 divided by 6. 24 is divisible by 2 and 3, therefore the number is divisible by 6 according to the rules. Now we are going to check it. 6 4s are 24. Now we are going to see that whether it is true for next statement. We are going to check it for number 14. This 14 is divisible by 2, we will get 7. But this 14 is not divisible by 3. We cannot get the whole number. So that number 14 is not divisible by 6. So these are all the examples. Next, divisible by 4. Next, divisible by 4. If last two digits are divided by 4, then the number is divisible by 4. We will check it. If last two digits are divisible by 4, the given number is divisible by 4. We will check it. Last two digits are divisible by 4, then it is divisible by 4. No need to check it for remaining numbers. Only last two digits we can check it. We will take number on our own. We will take 9, 4. We will take next last two numbers only, 24. Last two digits are divisible by 4. Last two digits 24, this 24 is divisible by 4. So we are going to say that this whole number is divisible by 4. We will check it. Is equal to, in 9 we have 2 4s are 8, remaining 1. In 14, 3 4s are 12, remaining 2. In 22, 5 fours are 20, remaining 2. Now 24, in 24, 6 fours are 24. So the given number is divisible by 4. Next we will take some other example. 7, 4, 3, 2, 8. We will check it. Last 2 digits 28 is divisible by 4. Last 2 digits 28 is divisible by 4. So we will check it whether it is correct. Is equal to, in 7 we have only 1 4 is there. Remaining 3. Now 34. In 34, 8 4s are 32. Remaining 2 is there. Now 23. In 23 we have 5 4s are 20. Remaining 3 is there. Now 32. 8 4s are 32. Now we have 8. 2 4s are 8. So 18582 is answer for the given question. But we found that only the last 2 digits. If last 2 digits are divisible by 4, then that whole number is divisible by 4. That is the divisibility rule. Next, divisible by 8. Divisibility by 8. If last 3 digits are divisible by 8, then the number is divisible by 8. Last 3 digits divisible by 8, then it is divisible by 8. For 4, last 2 digits is if the last 2 digits are divisible by 4, the entire number is divisible by 4. But for 8, last 3 digits are divisible by 8 means then it is divisible by 8. We will take number. Example. We will take the same number like this. 7, 4, 3, 5, 1, 2. Here, the last 3 digits, 512 is divisible by 8. We will check it whether it is true for all the number. 8. In 74, we have how many 8s are 72? 9 8s are 72. Remaining 2. So 23. In 23, we have 2 8s are 16. Remaining 7. Now 75. 9 8s are 72. Remaining 3. 31. In 31 we have 3 8s are 24. Remaining 7. 72. 9 8s are 72. So if last 3 digits are divisible by 8, then that whole number is divisible by 8. That is the divisibility rule for 8.